Let's come back home, talking about farm management, which is a very important aspect of agriculture, as we see increase in the number of youths and other investors engaging in the sector. But what more is involved in farm management as Nigeria faces rising food prices, especially of products that are grown in the country? Let's bring on Corporate Farmers, the award-winning Nigeria's most innovative farm management company of the year, at this year's Nigeria Brands Award, which was held last Friday. Welcome to the show, Akin Alabi and Ade Ajayi, co-founders of Corporate Farmers Nigeria. Good evening, gentlemen. Akin, you're sitting next to me right here on the table here. Right. So I'll say congratulations to you first.
Thank you.
And just in our newsroom studios is Ade, who is also a partner at the firm. Thank you, both of you, for coming through. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Bosen.
Yeah, your award, Akin, let me start with you, at the weekend was all about innovation in farm management. What is this practice, both in theory and on the ground, physically? Let me ask you in theory. Akin, Ade will answer me in practice. What does it mean, farm management? Tell me the theory part of it.
Basically, farm management, it's all about the ability to properly manage a commercial farm from setup to harvest and to market. Now, between those process, there is innovations, okay, that we cut across the entire process. Actually, we've managing farms now for over 15 years. And these awards for us is quite remarkable because over 15 years we've been practicing farm management, it's quite outstanding on how we've been able to add good level of innovation to every practices of our farm management method. And that is what we bring on the table. And that's what we've been doing over the years in changing the narrative and also engaging youth and also our stakeholders across the entire ecosystem on what farm management is, the practice, and how it's being done globally and also internationally in ensuring that we create wealth for our farmers today in Nigeria.
I want Ade Ajayi to take me to the farm. So let's get to the farm, Ade. In terms of what you call farm management, what is different from farm management in 21st century from what our parents did in the 20th century or 19th century?
Thank you so much, Bosin. You know, when you talk about the 21st century, is highly, a lot of changes has happened in this industry because, you know, when you look at my partner there talking about a digital agriculture, you know, when we are putting what we call the best practices in agriculture, and because people like us grown up, you know, in a farm environment and every other thing, looking at how this, you know, when we talk about subsistence farming, how it's being done as at that time in that generation. But the narrative has changed through technology and every other thing. And one of the unique area where people like us are so unique, and for several years of almost 20 years ago, I know that we have been in this business, is for us to look at it that look, agriculture is beyond farming. Agriculture is beyond the way all these olden days people are doing it. Because I do tell people that, look, when you look at agriculture, you know, when we are young as at that time, they are looking at it as such a way just to sustainability, not just to make money, not just to see it as a business. You know, it's just a sustainability. And that's why people like us have a better understanding of agriculture. And we are able to woo in the youth inside this agriculture. Because in those days, our parents are just using that money, using the proceeds from agriculture to just send us to school so that we don't return back to school. So that we don't return back to, you know, to farm. But now, because we have the better understanding that agriculture is a business, and then look at it, but we are putting a technology into it, and looking at the area where we have what we call human relationship, human capital development. When we get to any environment, that's what we call indigenous pattern of administration. We know how the Fulani people, you know, work, and their culture and every other thing. We'll be able to gather them together, get to that kind of environment, and set up a commercial farming in that kind of environment. And before you know it, we are developing what we call food security in Nigeria, food security in Africa, and making sure that because we have a better understanding of our people. You know, we have farm across Nigeria, Kebbi State, Kwara State, Kanji, Mokwa, name it. Because what we discover through the year of experience in this industry, we have a better understanding of our people of Nigeria. Nigeria is the best place to live in the world. And we are facing a lot of challenges now. I want people to know that the federal government need to do something about this insecurity. These are people that are not Nigerian, that are coming to Nigeria to disturb us. Fulani people are good people. Don't let anybody deceive you. We are the ones that are on the front liner. We are seeing them, and we know that the majority of people that are disturbing us in Nigeria are not Nigerians. And it is a responsibility of federal government to make sure that, look, all these people that are intruders coming to Nigeria, we chase them away. Because Nigeria is the next frontiers, and the youth are ready. In Corporate Farmers International, we put all these best practices to make sure that we establish commercial farming in all the environment that we find ourselves through all our clients. And because this is the only way you can help rural farmers. We, you know, when talk about, you know, yes, technology transfers and every other thing, we just, you know, we are planting nothing less than 100 hectares of maize in Kwara State now through our clients. And a lot of rural farmers are enjoying the technology transfer in that kind of environment.
So I'm about
this
to
is
ask
the best way that we can use it.
I wanted to ask Akin, because of our time, what you're hearing and learning on the ground about agriculture at the small scale, at the grassroots level, then folks still say that food prices are still high.
Yes, quite right. In terms of food price, it's still on the high price. And the reason is clear. We need to work more with small older farmers to get them together and ensure that we build them to be able to create and provide more for food security. Now, the issue of more of banditry, it's causing a lot of our farmers to migrate away from their farmland into another settlement entirely.
Are you seeing that in those places where you work?
Oh,
is
yes.
That part of what you're hearing?
Definitely.
On the ground?
No, for example, we're in Niger last year for a complete 3 months to farm soya beans and granite. We can't go back to Niger this year because of the level of insecurity. And this is what is happening to real farmers on ground. It's terrible. And when there is a shortage of food, automatically it means that there will be food insecurity. And it means also that our farmers will migrate from their location to another place totally from where they're supposed to farm and create wealth from themselves. So that is what is happening at the moment. And we need to step into that in ensuring that federal government help provide security for farmers, even on the front line as we go into the farm.
This is very interesting. I need to wrap it up for us. Your latest Nigeria Brands Award, what was involved, the process and all of that, when you talk about innovation in farm management by the Brands Award?
You see, when it talks about corporate farmer, we have two pillars that we call innovation and agribusiness. We bring innovations into agriculture, and they see the way we manage all the farms that are being given to us, you know, that we are managing for all our clients. We are talking about 50,000, you know, palm trees in Kogi State. We are talking about 100,000. You know, when it's all about best practices. That's why, you know, a lot of things is happening through us in Nigeria, and in order to make sure that we develop this nation and make sure that the only area where agriculture and where unemployment can be tackled is through agriculture. And then they look at that and then I said, wow, this company, Corporate Farmers International, through the year of experience, we are into it and make change in Nigeria.
Well, we'll say congratulations to you, Adia Jaya and Akin Alabi, co-founders at Corporate Farmers. If you guys are making money on the farm, let me be the first to know. But with these thousands of palm trees and whatever, it looks like money is being made over there. Those some folks are hiding in Lagos, thinking there's no money on the farm. I'm sure there's money there. That's why you folks are there. Thank you so much.
Thank you.